Now, a new work of art is put at the Newtown Junction and so far has received a positive response. Let's take a look at this insert.
For all of the public's past respect surrounding graffiti and street art in South Africa, it is now commonly accepted as a form of art. This year, the Newtown Junction has started a project that embraces the power and artistry of graffiti and supports the culture within the city. Dedicating a wall, artist Mfundo Rasiki recently finished his work, which is titled Joe Vendersburg. This is said to pay tribute to the female street vendors of the city, going out of their way to make a living.
Well, for one, I used to study here at Newtown Artist Proof Studio. And I used to, like, this was my hangout, basically. So I know all the ins and outs, you know. It's like kind of like another cultural precinct in a way, you know. So with that knowledge, I kind of had, you know, like to kind of, commemorate to people like Abu Hlubi, people that used to have stalls here, people like Abu Prince, the Prince of Newtown, you know, people that run Newtown precinct. So I kind of knew that. So that's why it was kind of secondary, or if I may say, it was kind of second nature for me to give this or to do this kind of artwork.
Mfundo, who hails from Orlando West, is committed to bringing the power of art to the community. For any artist, placement of the work is extremely important. The area of the widespread graffiti draws the attention of the unforgotten building to potential investors.
I think placement is very important. I normally use the word forgotten and neglected spaces. So I kind of beautify those forgotten and neglected spaces into beautiful and attractive places, you know. So that's kind of the play, you know. So we always want to utilize the spaces that are not necessarily seen and not necessarily, you know, noted.
Over the years, we have seen the form of art being accepted gradually by society. The art holds various meaning and it differs for each artist. It only recently experienced widespread corporate backing and interest in the public circles.
Graffiti has developed also in that sense. It has started from a normal tagging. Now we've made it into, you know, big mural pieces in every corner, you know. So, and we feel that with the gratitude and also the appreciation of the corporate, you know, it's a very important kind of important relationship that we need to build here, because we can't just put up any type of graffiti for the corporate to accept, you know. We need to put up the pretty pictures and like nice messages and like things that content that, you know, so that the piece can live longer as well.
The project will be part of a large body of work of a similar theme that includes A1 prints and collaborative children's books in Soweto.
There's bigger plans from here on. Definitely, we've been planning on doing the children's book. We've worked with people like Khanza Okhanye from Orlando West, where we've engaged with Tabisang Primary School. So those kind of projects that we've been on and we want to kind of take on the near future.
Like all great graffiti, Joe Vendersburg is fleeting in nature and can only be enjoyed for a few months before another artist is commissioned to showcase. In the meantime, many thousands of eyes will see the work of art and will be inspired by those it illustrates too. For Morning Live, I am Thapelo Moela.